My name is Zachary Nolan. Welcome back. Thank you so much for tuning in. If this is your first time, please hit the like button down below on the video and subscribe to the channel. We are trying to hit 1,700 subscribers. Hopefully before playoffs, but you never know. You never know. We're trying our best. Jets win 6-0 over the Anaheim Ducks. Hot diggity damn, we got a lot to cover here. We don't have the first two goal reactions because I had to work. That's why I'm wearing my work shirt and I'm exhausted. But hot diggity damn, we have the rest. As you can see, Carter was in attendance, so he does have the Tyler Toffoli goal reaction, kind of. The Appleton goal at the end, which is hilarious because Mason Appleton now has two goals at garbage time in two straight games. And the end of the game, love to see that. Let's get into this game. The Winnipeg Jets came out tonight and just made a statement win. Honestly, I wasn't worried about this game going in, I'll be honest. No disrespect to Anaheim fans. You're not where you... You're not competitive. I mean this in the nicest way. You're not competitive. You're not a competitive team. You are trying to tank. And I respect that. I do respect that a lot. First period, very decently competitive game. The Jets come out firing. Neil Pionk takes a penalty, which is dumb. A lot happens there, and I believe, and Kyle Connor gets a deflection goal in the first period. Great to see. Before we go into the second period, here's Carter's thoughts on the game.
And this is how you fucking carry on! Come on! Yeah!
Good morning, afternoon, and...
My turn, jackass!
Sweet! Get the fuck out of here!
Jets 6-0 win over the Anaheim Ducks. Thoughts in the game? Honestly, not much. Outplayed the Ducks majority of this game. It's funny, for a while, it felt like, you know, we were outplaying the crap out of them. However, it felt like we weren't putting the puck in the net until we really started doing that. Tyler Toffoli would get his first and second as a Jet tonight. And boy, oh boy, did they try to get him his third. They just kept feeding it to him constantly. It was awesome to see the warm reception to Toffoli. Overall, game was pretty good. Brassois got a shutout, was happy with that. There's a few calls here and there I didn't like. A few guys on Anaheim were selling a little bit, but it is what it is. 6-0 win, really nothing I can complain about. So back to Zach.
Also, Lauren Brassois net, obviously against John Gibson. Poor John Gibson. I don't want to say his career's been wasted in Anaheim, but there's a what if situation here. Like, what if he played somewhere else for this amount of times? Because honestly, like, yeah, he gives up 6 goals. He probably wants the DeMello goal back, but other than that, that dude was just getting shelled. That dude just got shelled tonight. I think all he wants back is the DeMello goal because I think DeMello beats him pretty cleanly. But we go to the second period. And Nate Schmidt gets his second of the season. He also got his first of the season against the Anaheim Ducks. So love to see that on the power play, no less, to double the lead. Then now we pretty much go to the third period. Before that, what time is it?
Moose watch.
Moose watch, baby, and oh yeah, we got some news to talk about. People keep telling me I have no idea. I have no concept of time when the AHL trade deadline is. I keep thinking I know when it is. I keep looking up. I thought it was 2 days after the NHL trade deadline. Then they made a trade today. So I'm like, okay, it must be today. And then I watched another YouTuber's video because, you know what? I sometimes watch, I do that. I don't do it overly often because I'll support them, but I won't watch them. You know what I mean? But he mentioned how the trade deadline's in a couple days. So I have no idea when it is, I guess. But the Manitoba Moose do make a trade here. And actually, it's on behalf of the Winnipeg Jets, they make a trade, which is a good trade. And I'm gonna just hear me out here, okay? Wyatt Bongiovanni. Now, by the way, check out my video on this because I'll go in-depth on this. But I'm going to quickly skim it because you should. It's a great video. And I'd appreciate your support on the transaction videos, which, by the way, secretly my favorite videos to record are transaction videos. Yep, I love the graphics. I love being able to talk about players coming in and out. I love it. Wyatt Bongiovanni is traded for future considerations to the Ottawa Senators. He's ineligible to play for the Ottawa Senators because it's after the trade deadline. He can only play for the Belleville Senators. Belleville is loading up for an all-in push, which makes sense. They also made a trade with the Carolina Hurricanes for a depth defenseman in the AHL. I actually am fine with this trade. Wyatt Bongiovanni, despite having about 2 1/8 of a season here, like he had 2 seasons here and he had 3 games in the other season, I was happy with his tenure as a Manitoba Moose. He put up solid numbers as a middle six forward, but he began to slowly get overtaken in the depth chart by other forwards. Parker Ford, especially last year, really put him under the hot seat as another college signing that kind of outperformed him. Also, injuries really deterred him. He had a hot start to the season. However, it was really deterred with injuries and just never fully got back to that pace that he had at the beginning of the year. It's a shame. I think a change of scenery is good for him. Also, it opens up a contract slot that can be used on Rutger McGroarty. If Rutger signs. When? No ifs. When? When Rutger signs with the Winnipeg Jets. Since, despite the fact that he was playing on the Moose, his contract was a two-way contract, so it falls under the behest of the Winnipeg Jets. Yeah. Hope Wyatt Bongiovanni enjoys Ottawa. Moose played tonight in Chicago against the Wolves, and they won 3-2 in a shootout. Jeff Mallott getting the shootout winner there. Great game. Check it out.
And now they trail, and now to the penalty kill, though. Billy Hanel jumps up into the play, snaps a shot, and he scores! Completely redeems himself! As Billy Hanela scores shorthanded to tie the game 1-1. Line by Lundmark. Green trying to make a play on the puck. Intercepted. Jones into the middle for Niekanen. He'll break right down the ice. Shoots right off the post. Jones the rebound. And he scores! Nicholas Jones finishes it off on the backhand. Comes to the left side. Weaving to the front. Fires. Scores! Jeff Mallott. Bar down! And the Moose chalk up the win. It's a 3-2 shootout.
Yes, also to Henry Niekanen has stayed red hot. Niekanen was great tonight. He's had such a season resurgence. He went the longest time without any points, and now he's got like 7 in his past 4 games. Great for him, honestly. For a guy who definitely needed to have a really good year, this is great to see. Thomas Milic looks solid. And yeah, no, that's basically a trade, which is surprising. But yes, we go to the third period. Dylan DeMello gets on the fucking score sheet, baby. Let's go. Woo! Let's go. Beautiful shot. Beautiful pass, beautiful shot. You love to see it. Let's go, Mello. The DeMello stands are going to love that one. Dylan DeMello, with a beautiful pass by Nick Ehlers. DeMello goal. Gibson wants this one back. Despite the fact that it's an unbelievable pass, Gibson has enough time to get his feet set and ready for this puck, and DeMello still hits him on the way through. Definitely would want that back. Jets keep it rolling, though, off the draw. Tyler fucking Toffoli, baby! Yes! Tyler Toffoli, baby! His first is a Jet! Yes, sir! Yes, sir! Let's fucking go! You'll love to see it. You'll love to see it. Tyler Toffoli with his first as a Winnipeg Jet. And then not to be outdone, Tyler Toffoli keeps going. This third period was owned by Tyler Toffoli. He scores again on a power play deflection reaction here. Yes! Let's go! He's got another! He can't be stopped! He can't be stopped! He was on hat trick watch now for most of the third period. He got a bunch of other looks, too. Like, this wasn't, like, a one and done or two and done. He got looks. He got, like, three other opportunities. And if this is the Tyler Toffoli we're getting, I'm so fucking ecstatic. Also worth noting, Colin Miller and Dylan Sandberg got the night off tonight, which I was okay with. Do I love Logan Nate Schmidt and Logan Stanley? No. However, load management, this is a game where... Like, yeah, sure, take the night off. Take like your bottom pair defenseman, you can take the night off. Have a lovely night out, boys. Relax. Jets keep it rolling though. Mason Appleton at garbage time makes it 6-0 reaction here. Yeah, that's pretty much it, honestly. The Jets run away with it. Brossoit gets shutouts in back-to-back games. You'll love to see it. I am so excited for Laurent Brossoit. I think he is going to get paid this offseason, and I'm really excited for that. He deserves the opportunity to be an NHL starter. I'm very excited for him, honestly. But yeah. Here's the women's side of hockey reaction here.
Women! 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 Women!
I don't know why I said reaction, but women's side of hockey. Only thing to report, yesterday's game ended with a 4-0 win for PWHL Minnesota over Boston. Again, the playoffs is a cluster. Three teams still holding top three positions, with the fourth being pretty much up for contention for any of the teams. Minnesota, Montreal, and Toronto are pretty much locked into playoff spots at this rate. They're keeping pace, and then Ottawa, New York, and Boston are fighting for that fourth spot. That's literally how it's coming down to the wire right now. So yeah. But yeah, three stars of the game. Laurent Brossoit has to get first star. It's another shutout for LB. Love to see it. Tyler Toffoli gets second star. Third star will be, Dylan DeMello, shall we say. Yes, sir, we will. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave a like down below and subscribe and comment your thoughts on this game. And do check out our Wyatt Mongiovanni trade video, because it's my favorite type of video to do, a transaction video. Thanks so much for watching, and we will see you next time when your Winnipeg Jets take on the Columbus Blue Jackets.
One, Nikolai Ehlers chips it through, gets around, and he shoots and scores! What a